Chris, we all make a lot of hay out of, and rightfully so, the run that Brady just went on, right?
Remarkable. I still can't
remarkable,
believe it.
Still can't remarkable believe it. Run to send Brees into retirement. Check.
Check.
Win a game, an NFC championship game for the first time in your career, and of all places, vaunted Lambeau Field, to also make Aaron Rodgers another 12 think about his future.
Yep.
Check.
Check.
Okay, those are two first ballot Hall of Famers.
Correct.
And then when the young buck is coming for your crown and you need to protect your home turf in a Super Bowl, the first team to ever play in their home building in the Super Bowl, you beat Patrick Mahomes. You beat him back, right? Check, check,
check.
Okay.
Check.
So the check for Brady.
He did all that.
Who are we forgetting?
Well, his first, you know, wild card opponent, the Washington football team, Taylor Heinicke.
Taylor Heinicke, who, as you know, had an outstanding game, kind of gave maybe in a way the Bucs their toughest game. I know Devin White wasn't playing in that game, but remember he reached out for the pylon, hit him with the Heinicke?
Hit him with the Heinicke.
Right? It was amazing. And then you're thinking, hey, maybe this guy's got a spot. Alex Smith goes, right? And then you're thinking, this guy maybe has a real chance to start for this team.
Yeah.
I mean,
got an extension.
Look at what he got. And he was what a story, right? He's sitting at home.
Yep.
Thanksgiving time. And they reach out to him, say, hey, look, you know, Kyle Allen's done for the year. And Alex Smith is, you know, dicey. We just cut it. We got to cut Dwayne Haskins because he's spending time at the club. And we're throwing him out of ours. Like, we need your help, Travis. You know, Taylor, we need your help.
Yeah.
But by the way, I don't mean to call you Travis, Taylor. I mean, that might have actually been
that
part
might
of the
have
conversation.
Happened.
I mean, he's sitting at a couch. And then he's performing a playoff game. Everybody watches on NBC. And it's amazing. And now he's got a shot.
Shot.
As of just... Yesterday, he was the only guy on the roster.
Yesterday.
Sorry, Taylor.
Oh, no.
Really, you had a great run.
Oh, no.
Because the Washington football team has signed Ryan Fitzpatrick. And we could sit here and say, there's going to be a quarterback controversy. We could sit here and say that. We could sit here and say there's going to be a competition. We could say that. And there's no controversy. I mean, Fitzpatrick is a beloved figure wherever he goes. Everybody loves to be his teammate. It is infectious what he does in the locker room, on the field. And then, you know, he mentors. Guy mentors. I mean, Tua, he was an invaluable source for him after he got benched in favor of the rookie, right? But everywhere he goes, he'll start. Everywhere he goes, something's going to happen. Football gods, even if you win the job in the summer and you've earned it, I'm sorry, bud. Everywhere Fitzpatrick goes, he winds up starting. And I'll tell you this, man, he is going to be a fun watch in 2021. He will be outstanding watch in the Washington-Dallas rivalry. Ryan Fitzpatrick in the Jones Mahal in the NFC East money game of Washington v. Dallas is going. Dak versus Ryan Fitzpatrick is going to be a blast. A blast. Jalen Hurts versus Ryan Fitzpatrick is going to be a front row seat, must see fun football game. Daniel Jones, I can go higher register on that. But I can't wait. I can't wait because he's going to fit. Terry McLaurin's going to go off. We're going to draft him in fantasy. Terry McLaurin's going to go off.
Terry McLaurin's going to catch bombs.
And Chase Young's going to keep putting this bearded wonder back on the field. And I can't wait to watch it. I am so fired up. Bearded wonder. There's no question that Ryan Fitzpatrick is bringing the best beard seen in D.C.
since
Rutherford B. Hayes.
Yeah.
Look at that on the screen right there.
That was nice yesterday.
That was a good one.
Oh, yeah. 1881 was the last time we've seen a beard like this in Washington, D.C.
Come on.
I looked it up. Take that, Michael Beschloss. Okay?
You lost me there.
Oh, he's a presidential historian.
Yeah, he's a good Twitter follower.
But,
yeah.
I mean, this is going to be I cannot wait. Great signing by Ron Rivera and the Washington football team. And my apologies, Taylor Heinicke. You had a great run, man.
So how many games are we talking for Fitzmagic here? 4, 6?
12!
Come on.
Over, under 12. I'm taking the over.
How many wins for Ryan Fitzpatrick?
I would take... They can win 9, 10 games with him. There's no question. There's no question.
Are we over-evaluating Ryan?
We are not.
Fitzpatrick.
I say this with no hint of irony or higher register. Ryan Fitzpatrick should be in the Hall of Fame.
Oh, my gosh. Oh.
Now yeah. We need to pump those brakes a little bit.
So let me get this straight. Frank Gore should not be in the Hall of Fame, but Ryan Fitzpatrick should be in the Hall of Fame.
You can tell the story of the NFL without Frank Gore. You cannot tell the story of the NFL without Ryan Fitzpatrick. You guys are
well,
nuts.
Hold on a second. I'm going to block all the hate tweets that he's about to get for just saying that.
We'll put a point. We'll put a period on it because we have to get to Michael Lombardi.
What?
Wait till the end of this season to see if you're right, because this team has a terrific defense and a lot of weapons that Ryan Fitzpatrick, I'm telling you, is going to start a ton of games. And I apologize, Taylor Heineke. You may win the job. You're not keeping it. He's going to be dynamite. I can't wait. Hey, you watched all the way to the end. Thanks for that. Watch more right here.